Hey guys, it's Toniko, Pantoja. And lately, I've been thinking about doing these really small and short videos where I talk about things that I learned throughout my career, throughout my education in art and animation, making a reflection about it and seeing why those teachings and preachings can be problematic. And I'm going to talk about, let's say, just about two or three of them per video. You know, keep it short. And of course, the things I'm going to say, many of you will disagree with me, and that is totally fine. I mean, it's all about gaining perspective, informing your own opinion, rather than just follow what is commonly agreed on. Now, the first one I want to cover is that you must be good at drawing before you try to do animation. To work in 2D animation and to study in a school where 2D animation plays a dominant role in the education, it is highly recommended and I guess required to have good foundation for your drawing skills. And the reason why most of these schools look for people who have solid draftsmanship is because the animation courses are fast-paced and you're dealing with a lot of drawing and consistent character animation for your assignments. And you'll see it in many schools. CalArts, Sheridan, Gobelin, they all look for good draftsmanship for their potential students. However, I don't agree that you have to be good at drawing before you even try animation. Animation and drawing are fundamentally two different things, and solid draftsmanship or solid drawing is only 1/12 of the principles of animation of what makes good animation. You're introducing spacing, timing, acting, all these other things that drawing can't just do by itself. You know, there's a lot of people who get accepted into the animation degree courses who are exceptional artists who can draw really well, but they don't really enjoy animating or doing 2D animation. And of course, you get students in these courses who tend to brag about how much work they realize 2D animation is. But to someone who has experimented with 2D animation, regardless of drawing skill, it's familiar territory. One thing we have to also acknowledge is that there's also a good number of people who started animating with weak drawing skills, but they got a fundamental understanding of what animation is like, and eventually they enjoyed it to the point where they became serious about learning more about it, even to the point of wanting to learn how to draw better. The online animators who work in anime shows, most of them started out as stick animators, just doing stick animation fight scenes, and then eventually learned how to improve their own draftsmanship skills, learning how to draw, but they already had a strong fundamental understanding of what animation is like. So in that case, one can learn animation and then suddenly become interested in it where they realize, oh, I need to up my drawing skills. So they will go into learning how to draw better, already knowing what it's like to animate. That also helps too. So if you're interested in animation, I would say start as soon as possible regardless of drawing skill. And no matter what drawing skill you're at, you're going to benefit from it. However, I do agree that in order to get better at drawing, you need to spend more time on just drawing studies, just so that you can embrace more of that department. And if you want to try animation, there's a lot of free programs out there, and a lot of great Discord communities where you can just hop in, look at work, show your work, and get feedback. It's that accessible nowadays. Also, if you want to get a feeling of what animating is like while at the same time improve your drawing skills, I made a video talking about just copying frames from live action movies and how to do it, so please check that video out. The next one I want to talk about is the only great way to animate is on paper. You're only a true 2D animator if you can animate on paper, traditional style. My initial gut reaction to this is that this is such an entitled thing to say because as someone who grew up where there isn't really an animation industry or there isn't really a career choice for that, you don't really have access to these resources that allow you to do traditional animation stuff even if you wanted to do it. First of all, you'd need an animation desk setup. So things like an animation disc, a light table, an animation peg bar, animation paper, and if you don't have animation paper, you'd have to invest in an animation peg bar hole puncher, which of course not many people have access to anymore. Oh, and don't forget, you need a down shooter so you can shoot everything and put it into an animation video. And all of that combined, including the cost of art materials, restocking on paper, and even having the space for that, can be quite expensive. So it is a luxury to have. I remember when I was still at school and I had to fly back home, I only had my laptop and my Graphire 3 tablet so I could practice or animate during the summer. And sometimes I would show these studies to an animation teacher or mentor, and I would show them my animation test that was done in Flash, and then they would go on a tirade going on about like how animation should only be learned by doing things on paper, and the things that are holding me back is because I am animating digitally. But it's not like I'm gonna bring my animation desk and everything from the United States to, let's say, Jakarta. One thing that I will agree though that many traditional 2D animators criticize over digital 2D animators is that most most of the digital 2D animators just, you know, animate, they just play it, they go, oh shoot, that doesn't look right, let me try this, and they keep repeating, play it, repeating, readjusting, things like that, to the point where they're just mindlessly doing something without planning their animation. And you keep playing it again and again, and you can't really figure out why it's not working, that can be problematic. However, there are great 2D animators that have never animated on paper, but are exceptional animators who animate in that traditional style sensibility. And of course, you can still learn animation however you can, whether it's from a free program online, whether it's from a well-known digital 2D animation software. However, I will say that animating on paper is a great learning experience overall. You learn how to utilize charts, exposure sheets, organizing your drawings, because organizing your drawings and then putting it onto a down shooter just to see how it looks being played does take up a lot of time. And in a lot of cases, that's time we can't afford to just lose. So it does teach you how to prioritize your planning, discipline, and really think about your decisions and your animation rather than just wing it mindlessly. And the more time you spend time thinking things through consciously, you spend way less time just trialing and erroring it. And of course, you can replicate this feeling digitally too. You can have a traditional exposure sheet on your site if you wanted to learn how to use that. You can force yourself to use charts. Or you'd refrain from pressing the play button once in a while. So my conclusion to this, animating on paper is a great way to learn 2D animation. And there's a lot of great resources where you can find budget options for that if you really wanted to do that. But learn however you can based on whatever resource is available to you. What matters the most is the type of work you come out with it. Another one that I'd like to talk about is often preached by recruiters, people in the studios, and teachers who have had major experience from the studios, which is good animation should be entertaining. The word entertaining bugs me. One could say that this just means it could be funny, crazy, wild, with strong poses, silhouettes, pushed expressions, exaggeration. You know, anything that screams fun factor, how good animation should always have great poses, great acting choices, etc. But that certain mentality kind of gatekeeps of what animation should be, rather than what else animation can be. So personally, I'm not against what the original intention of what this idea of animation should be entertaining mean. And what this really comes down to, and this should be preached more often so than animation is entertainment, is that good animation should be engaging. A scene where a character is just maybe setting their bed or putting on their clothes in the most mundane way can also be super engaging if we have clear intentions and what we're trying to say within that shot or sequence. Things like the storytelling elements, what the characters are thinking, what their attitudes are, how they're breathing. You don't need to resort to these golden acting choices, strong poses, push exaggeration poses, pay faces, whatever. I would say just be sincere and honest with your work, rather than just try to do things because some idiot said pushing and exaggerating things and using asymmetry and good design means good animation. And ask yourself questions all the time of what is so engaging about an animated shot or an animation piece that you're trying to do. Engaging could be fun, entertaining, but engaging can also be subtle, dramatic, sad. Engaging can also be mundane. Engaging can also be experimental, nonsensical, freeform. And these are things that can make animation work more original. And there's a lot of ways you can do that. So when I talk about honesty and sincere with your animation work or artwork, you don't want to go about it thinking that, oh, I'm only doing this because some person from Disney said this was the right thing to do, or because some professional said so. And if you're trying to get work in a studio like Disney where they say this is how we do it in this studio, that's a completely different story. And of course, one would have to cater their portfolio or demo reel to fit with their standards. But to say that their way is the only way to do correct or right, entertaining or engaging animation is ludicrous. And sometimes to get honest and sincere animation, sometimes you have to disregard what has been preached to you. So those are some teachings and preachings that I have received as a professional and as a student. Now, there's a lot of other teachings and preachings that I was often told and that I have more strong opinions about, but that's all for another video. If you guys have some that you'd love to share that you were often told and you have some mixed feelings about, let me know. Anyways, that's all I'm going to talk about. Bye. Interested in learning hand-drawn animation or learning how to finish an animated shot from beginning to end? Have a look at the store where you'll find the complete Introduction to 2D Animation video course, tutorials, and other resources. Learn classical animation approaches, drawing, lectures, techniques, and other process videos. Visit the store through the link in the description below.